Previously on Kyle's Y.
Did you find something out about Kyle?
It looks like it.
I think Kyle may be connected to a murder.
Some hikers found it near Victor Falls.
The other night, we found Kyle sitting right next to this spot.
Well, you yourself said that trauma may have caused his amnesia.
Well, yes, it's possible he witnessed the attack.
Has he started to remember anything?
It doesn't mean that I expect this big commitment, just the truth.
I bet your family's searching for you right now. You didn't just fall from the sky.
This symbol was on some sort of security key card we found near the remains.
Does this mean anything to you?
No. It was my first dream, at least the first I could remember. My subconscious mind was weaving a tale of love and loss, even though my memories contained no such stories. I wondered what it meant. Was it something I had already experienced, or simply a vision of things to come? I wished to go back to that moment with Amanda. I wanted to see how it would end.
You sure he didn't draw this after he saw the key card?
No, I noticed these markings on his drawings well before.
Kyle, why did you draw this in pieces?
That's how I saw it.
It's possible that fractured pieces of his past are starting to enter his consciousness. I've seen it before in patients who have trauma-based amnesia.
Everyone was concerned about the images coming from my head. I couldn't explain them any more than I could explain my dream about Amanda. My mind was doing things the rest of me didn't understand.
Where are you going, Lori?
Where are you going, Lori?
The pool?
You know, last time I checked, looking after Kyle actually meant looking after Kyle.
But he's busy.
Actually, we're done here. For now.
Kyle, do you want to go to the pool?
I'm the only girl in America who has to babysit a fully grown teenager.
Take your brother, too, because we have to go to the high school to register Kyle.
Choice? What if I don't want to go to the pool?
Maybe you don't want to spend the rest of the day with your summer reading list, either.
I'll get my stuff.
Fabulous.
Years of service to the company, Tom. Sorry to see you go. Time to move on. this your forwarding address? Good. The company likes to keep in touch, especially now with Kern still MIA.
I'm sure you'll track him down.
Goes without saying. Friendly reminder. You know how aggressively we enforce these confidentiality agreements. But one more thing. Your security card.
Of course.
Stay at least 20 feet from me at all times. Close enough I can see you're in trouble, far enough away I can choose to ignore it.
Lori! Come on! Over here!
And don't drown.
I'll tell you, brother. Give a woman an ounce of power and she'll run right over you.
Why is Amanda sitting up there?
She's a lifeguard.
She guards life?
Sorta. She'll jump in to save you if you can't swim.
He's like seriously manorexic.
Eat a sandwich!
Yo, Traeger.
What's up? Him for lying? Are we back to the whole playing hard to get game?
Not a game. I'm over it.
Really?
Really?
So you're not secretly yearning he'll call you over?
Nope.
And you're not quietly wishing he'd sit here with you?
Not in the least.
And somewhere deep in your subconscious, you have no desire to sleep with him at Preston's party Friday. Even though we both swore we wouldn't go back to school with our virginities intact.
My virginity, yours hasn't been an issue for quite some time.
Whatever. Are you serious? You're really over him.
I'm done with the whole friends with benefits thing. It's not fun anymore. We're not really friends, which means we're just benefits, and if I'm gonna be giving benefits to anyone, it should mean something.
Look who's all protective of her first time! You wanted to sleep with Declan for, like, ever.
I still do, but I'm not giving it up to some guy whose idea of fun is crawling into my bedroom drunk at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Well, we'll just have to find you another de-virginizing opportunity. Like yummy goodness over there.
Ew. Hillary.
Fine. I'll take him.
You are so not allowed to corrupt Kyle.
Why not?
Because it's, like, wrong.
When do we swim?
We don't come here to swim. We come here to scope babes.
Babes?
You know, the ladies. Hot mamas. Girls with C cups. Like her. Good Lord of the Rings.
Is she a friend of yours?
Dude, a chick like that doesn't know I exist.
So you won't go talk to her?
Talk to her? Are you nuts?
So we come to the pool, but don't swim. And we scope babes, but we don't talk to them?
It's a cruel world. I just live in it. Jesus. Don't move. Lori, my favorite sister of all time.
No.
Come on, go in the bathroom. Seriously, go in the girls' locker room. Get the name and the number of the girl in the pink bikini with the polka dots on her whatnots.
Her whatnot? Forget it.
Look, you're gonna go in there right now, or I'm gonna yell, Lori Traeger sucks her bra at the top of my lungs.
You are the devil. You manipulative little freak.
He has no records, no history of school.
As I explained, Kyle's situation is unique.
It certainly is. But he's exceptionally bright. You're requesting a one-on-one tutor. That's an expensive arrangement.
Legally, you're obligated to provide it.
Are you sure he wouldn't be better suited for a special ed program?
He's not disabled.
I'm sure. But to be fair, high school can be a very difficult experience even for the most well-adjusted students. If this boy is special, it may not be the easiest of transitions for him.
I assume you'll pass our request up the administrative ladder.
Of course.
Good.
Did you find her?
There is one girl in there. Gorgeous, great body. She's in the shower right now. Naked.
That's her.
That's impossible. Josh, she's a 10. There is no way a girl that hot would come within a mile of you.
Get back in there and find out her name.
It's not her.
Quit messing around, Lori.
Quit bugging me, Josh.
Lori Traeger stops her bra.
Josh Traeger has wet dreams.
You are so dead.
You guys, where's Kyle?
It felt just like my dream. And just like Josh said, she came to help me.
Is he okay? How long was he under?
My whole body tensed and tingled. I suddenly felt a strange sort of pressure. Good pressure.
No way!
Nerve implying Kyle didn't belong there.
Hooper's not an educator. He's a bureaucrat worried about the bottom line.
He was totally inappropriate.
Well, he's not subtle, that's for sure, but he has a point. Hey, honey.
Houston, we have a problem.
What's up?
Funny you should ask.
Rough day? You want to talk about what happened? At the pool?
You mean?
Yeah.
Everybody laughed at me.
And you don't know why?
No.
You never had an erection before?
Not that I can remember.
Okay, then. Well, first of all, you have to understand that what happened to you was completely normal. You just don't typically want it to happen in public.
And it's not normal.
No, it is. It's your body's way of telling you how you feel. In fact, it's a very honest physical response.
Then why should it be hidden?
Well,
hi.
Hello?
Is Lori around?
Declan. Hi. Thanks, Mom.
You're welcome. Come in.
So, you're, at my house.
Yeah.
In daylight, through the front door.
Who'd have thunk?
Why?
I didn't see you leave the pool.
Yeah, I had to bail.
Anyway, Hillary said you'd be home.
We still haven't covered the why part yet.
I thought you might want to go to Preston's party on Friday.
Of course, everyone's going.
I meant, with me.
Oh.
All this back and forth, Traeger, I'm tired of it. And I'm sorry for whatever I did to piss you off. I think it's time we went out together. Really went out. But if you're not into it...
No, I'm into it.
Well, good. So we'll go.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, do you want me to, like, pick you up or something?
I can meet you there.
Sounds like a plan. All right. Later, Traeger.
Later.
Okay, look. I've been on the other side of that talk. It ain't pretty.
You said when it happens again in front of people, I should think of something I don't like.
Totally. I usually go with zits and old people. You?
Grapefruit.
You should know there are other ways to handle a little problem. Ta-da!
Charlotte?
No. Charlotte's mine, dude. You are not ready for Charlotte. Meet Ginger.
What do I do with it?
Look at it.
Like at the pool. Scope babes.
Except when you're here alone, you can lock your door and do other things.
Is Kyle around? I feel horrible about what happened today.
Straight back other side of the kitchen.
I have to go.
Mm-hmm.
How'd you like to get out of watching Kyle for a couple hours every day?
I'm listening.
Well, I can make it happen. In exchange for Miss Pink Bikini's digits.
Are we still on that?
Are you interested or not?
Of course.
Hi, Mom.
What do you want?
So, Lori and I were thinking maybe we shouldn't bring Kyle to the pool today. I mean, not after yesterday.
Because of the incident?
No, I was more worried about the whole drowning thing.
What drowning thing?
Kyle doesn't know how to swim.
Well, that's no reason he should miss out on going to the pool. We should get him lessons.
That's a great idea. They offer lessons down there. A couple hours every day. He'll be swimming in no time.
Amanda, your next lesson's here.
Thanks.
She hates me.
Just don't hump her leg and you'll be fine. Hi, you're Ashley, right?
Yeah.
Hi, can I talk to you for a second? Mission accomplished. Ditch responsibility and pay off the debt all at once.
You know, I'd happily give Kyle swimming lessons. I'd show him the breaststroke.
Okay, you're seriously grossing me out.
Okay, Prudy.
Please, I'm so not a prude.
Yeah, just a virgin.
By a very minor technicality. Besides, I decided you're right about the sex thing.
You're kidding.
Well, it's not like I'm waiting for true love, and the only reason I've held out this long is he hadn't done anything to deserve it, but he was finally stepping up. There's no reason why I shouldn't.
So, cup your hand and pull the water along with you. You have to float.
Float.
Yeah, you know. You don't know. Here. See? Let the water hold you up.
Great fruit.
Her name is Ashley Redmond. She's your age. Catholic school. You better call now and get the humiliation over with.
Sweet, thanks.
Whatever.
Buoyancy, strokes, breathing. It all made sense in theory. Now it was time to put it into practice.
Where'd he go?
It must be a great teacher.
Are you sure you've never been swimming before?
Yesterday,
That wasn't swimming, that was drowning. You don't have a belly button.
No.
Why not?
I don't know.
And you still don't remember anything about your life before?
No.
But you can jump up tall buildings and swim like an Olympic champion.
Josh thinks I'm an alien.
Or Superman.
You're not angry anymore.
I never was. I just thought your drawings were kind of weird.
Why?
There were a lot of me.
I draw everything exactly how I see it in my head. You're special. I can't seem to get you right.
How come?
Seems like there's something missing.
My mom's gonna be out tomorrow afternoon. Come by my house. I'm gonna show you something.
Hey. I spoke to Detective Breen again.
Did he have anything new about the logo?
Nothing. The logo doesn't match any corporation on record. And they haven't been able to decrypt the computerized strip on the key card.
Well, that must be some sophisticated security system, whatever it's for.
Oh, this worries me, Stephen. You have no idea what Kyle might have witnessed.
Well, you're doing what you can to help him remember.
Well, maybe now's not the best time to send him to school.
Oh, please tell me you're not letting that vice principal get to you.
Well, he's right. I want to protect Kyle, not thrust him into another traumatizing experience.
Don't you think he should try to live like a normal teenage boy?
I'd feel better if I believed he was normal.
Something's been bothering me. I thought we should have a little chat. Your key card. I ran it through the system to deactivate it, and the clearance code didn't match your assignment. Strange. That's what I said. Thought maybe it was a computer error. And then I discovered that Curran was cleared to that level. Interesting coincidence, him being missing and all. I thought it might be a piece of information you might find worth something. Something you might want me to keep quiet. Feeling you don't want the company to know what you've been up to.
Too. Not for like a living. It was his thing.
Was.
He died last year.
He's what's missing.
Anyways, take a look.
Yeah. He saw this in his head?
Kind of. Art is about drawing what you feel, not just what you see.
How do you draw a feeling?
It's like piano. Right now, I'm just playing notes. But art is about putting your whole self into something. Everything you feel.
How do you feel?
Just listen.
I didn't know that I could make a picture of how I felt inside, but I really wanted to try.
Hello? Josh Traeger?
Hi?
I saw the caller ID. Your sister said I would hear from you.
She did?
I'm totally psyched.
You are?
Are you going to Jeff Preston's party tonight? I don't know him, but everyone goes, right?
Right.
Awesome. So, see you there.
Wardrobe crisis?
The usual.
I love that red shirt you have.
I think I'm gonna go with the blue.
Josh wants to go to the party. I know you have a date.
Date? Mom, so 80s.
Okay, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, I was gonna say no, and then he went into this whole sales pitch about how it's a rite of passage into high school.
He's sort of right. But don't worry, it's chaperoned. And I'll look out for him. Unless he embarrasses me, in which case I will kill him.
Thank you, Lori. So this Declan, is he a good guy?
Most of the time.
You're coming to the party.
I don't like parties.
You have to come. Everyone goes.
And Amanda?
Guaranteed.
Good, I have something for her.
Great, bring it. Get dressed.
Bye, guys.
Kyle, you're not going.
Sorry. See you midnight, Kyle and Josh. 10 o'clock or you won't live to see 10:01.
But...
Go ahead, have a good time.
Don't you come around.
I underestimated you, Tom. I never thought the quiet guy from work would replace you.
See Ashley.
Or Amanda.
Should have known it was too good to be true.
Hi, Josh.
Ashley. Hey.
I'm so glad you made it. I don't know anyone here. Come on.
Sure.
Thanks. I was going for naughty and nice.
It's working.
Yo, Preston.
Oh, hey, what's up, guys?
Great party.
Yeah, it'd be better if my parents weren't lurking. But I hit a bunch of beer around the property, so help yourselves.
Thanks, man. Thirsty?
Always.
Sweet.
I didn't bring a suit.
Damn. Me neither. What are you doing?
I don't want to get my clothes wet. What are you doing?
Checking for the hidden cameras.
You're funny.
It's my thing.
Sorry. Sister Mary Lourdes would definitely not approve.
What she doesn't know won't hurt her.
This is totally fun. When I saw you at the pool the other day, I was hoping you'd come talk to me.
What?
I thought you were cute.
You did.
Well, there aren't any other boys at my school to compare you to. But yeah.
What the hell is going on?
Mr. and Mrs. Preston?
Get out of there right now.
Honey, come on.
Young man.
I can't. Sit, old people.
I'm gonna count to three. One, two.
Great for you! It gets better.
Well, better get back to the party.
Everyone thinks I'm a slut just because of the 8th grade field trip to Tacoma.
I just want a sweet guy to cuddle with. That's so wrong. Feel nice.
Hillary made my body feel good, but just like the girls in Josh's magazines, something didn't feel right. There was a piece missing.
Hillary, get off of him.
Go away.
God, you slut.
Ow!
I told you to leave him alone.
What are you so worried I'll do?
Gee, I wonder.
Do you really think I'm such a super skis? You've held out on one thing and you act like the freaking purity police.
That's not what I'm
tired of it. Poor Declan. I never should have told him to ask you out.
What?
I told him you weren't gonna put out anymore unless he stepped up.
She didn't say it like that. That's not what.
Don't talk to me. You two totally did it, didn't you?
Who knew after all this time, you'd be so easy?
Declan, man, dude, you gotta come check this out. It's hilarious.
Wait. Hey.
Speaking part of the evening.
How could you let him go to that party?
We let Josh go, and he's younger.
Well, I'm not worried about Josh being able to handle himself.
And I'm not worried about Kyle.
But he is...
Listen, Nicole, you need to ease up on the reins just a little bit. Kyle needs to get out there and experience life. He needs to have it knock him around a little bit.
We took him in so we could protect him.
Not by keeping him in a bubble. All right, look. I realize that he's your patient.
Yes. But it's hard for me to stay clinical about him.
Of course it is. So let's handle him like we handle Josh and Lori. The reason they're well adjusted is because we treat them with respect. We let them go out there and make their mistakes, and they know we're here when they need us. You need to give Kyle the same chance.
I hope you're right.
Had to happen sometime.
So, finally tapped that, huh?
No, man. She's not like that.
Seeing Amanda, I realized something. I had been struggling to understand what my mind and body were trying to tell me. And right then, I knew what it was. Everything was working together, sending a message to my heart.
Kyle!
Amanda!
There you are. I've been waiting for you.
Oh, Charlie, this is my neighbor, Kyle. Kyle, this is Charlie, my boyfriend.
Hey, nice to meet you, man.
And now my heart was sending a message to the rest of my body.
You guys live across the street from each other.
Pain.
Next door, yeah, I just...
Burning on the bridge, turning off the lights. We're on the run, I can see it in your eyes. If nothing is safe, I don't understand. You call me a boy, but I'm trying to be the man.
Life is a puzzle. Every piece fits together to create who we are, what we do, how we feel. Every experience shapes us into who we will eventually become. I began as a blank slate. Maybe my hidden memories tell a different story. Maybe I hold the key to a mystery even greater than that of my past.
Got nowhere to go and no home that's left.
I've been so eager to remember, to grow up and experience life like Lori and Josh. But in that one moment, I wished I could go back to that blank slate. And life was easier. I think they wished for it, too.
Ready?
Let's go home.